If you're watching in Chennai, listen closely. Jayalalithaa might just be prevented from contesting active polls as long as 2024. That's right. She's already been facing trouble. And we are being told by our legal sources that she is now facing a 10-year election debacle. This has come following her conviction, remember, in that disproportionate assets case, for which she has been sentenced already to 4 years in jail. Adding to the woes of Jayalalithaa, a 10-year ban from contesting elections could mean an end to an illustrious political career, at least as a campaigner, as well as an MLA and a chief minister in her own right. Jaya is 66, and the ban will end 10 years later. She'll be 76 by then. She's currently, remember, out on bail after the Supreme Court suspended her sentence last month and gave her till the 18th of next month to file an appeal for suspension. Guess who's thrilled about it? 76 by then. She's currently, remember, out on bail after the Supreme Court suspended her sentence last month and gave her till the 18th of next month to file an appeal for suspension. Guess who's thrilled about it?
Law says, the Representation of People's Act says that anybody who is punished of a crime, was awarded a punishment of 2 years imprisonment or more, will not be eligible to contest elections for the period of conviction and 6 years, plus 6 years. So now she was imprisoned for 4 years and plus 6 years makes 10 years. For the next 10 years she cannot contest elections. That is as per law. So,
see, what the Tamil Nadu government is now doing is just a legal requirement. It's a technical legal requirement they have to do. And the case is on appeal. So ultimately it is appeal that will decide her fate. And as of now, the appeal cannot be disposed of before February next year. So only by February next year, we'll really know what happens to Jayalalithaa. As of now, there's a legal requirement that is being complied with. I'm happy that the Tamil Nadu government doesn't hesitate to announce this.
With the Tamil Nadu government issuing a gazette notification on the disqualification of former Chief Minister Jayalalithaa, it has merely completed a legal requirement. Analysts say the real test for the former Chief Minister will be post the appeal, which will be next year. With the AIADMK and Jayalalithaa synonymous to each other, the new Chief Minister struggles to find a foot in governance. In Chennai, with video journalist Balasubramaniam, Lokpriya, NewsX.
All right, let's get you some perspective. Two very renowned political analysts, S. Murari and Suman C. Raman, on the phone line with me. Mr. Raman, let me come to you first. It's not over till it's over. I know there's an appeal process still pending, but Jayalalithaa has sort of gone underground, hasn't she, for the past few weeks? She hasn't come out, and really a 10-year political exile, that's pretty bad, isn't it?
No, I don't think that the 10-year political exile is the final position. It's actually the position following the judgment, subject to the result of the appeal. And the appeal process is well underway, and I think by December 18th, the papers for the appeal will have to be filed. So this is just a legal statutory requirement that the government has to do following the conviction which happened. So I really would not take this, I don't take this to have any specific significance or impact. In the sense that this is something which has to be done by the government, okay, following the conviction, and they cannot wait till the appeal is over.
All right, so okay. Mr. Raman, stay with me. Mr. Murari, the appeal process is Suman C. Raman is pending. Of course, that's pending. That's the legal right of every citizen, not just Jayalalithaa. But sometimes the appeal process takes as much as 2 years. So 2 years itself would mean preclude her from the next assembly election campaign. That's devastating.
Yeah, it's not just that. She has to be acquitted. The chances are very, very remote. So at the best, you know, she can hope. I'm being very realistic. I've gone into details of the judgment. At best, she can ask for, even if the sentence is reduced, it will not be any relief. She has to be acquitted. Even if the moment she is convicted, she stands disqualified for 6 years. And that disqualification will come into effect after she serves the sentence. That means 4 years versus 10 years. Even if the sentence is reduced to 2 years, it only means 8 years.
Yes.
So she has to get outright acquittal.
Yeah, outright acquittal. That's the underlining point. Before I pull in M.R. Venkatesh, let me do the mathematics for our viewers who are watching with interest. If she goes into jail to serve the term, that's 4 years in jail, then the People's Representation Act says that after you come out, for another 6 years, you can't contest. You're barred from contesting. That's 10 years in total. If the appeal process goes on for 2 years, until she is acquitted, really, in the appeal process, if that happens, even while she has not been acquitted and the appeal is underway, she still can't contest. Having put those thoughts across, M.R. Venkatesh, how do you see this? This is pretty devastating news.
Well, this is well known. I think on 27th September, when she was convicted, all of us knew for 4 plus 6 years she would not be in a position to contest. And the impact probably is felt today. But the real fact is that day itself we knew, because the trial court judge, the moment he had given the order, in the last few sentences, he also orders for a fax message to be given to the Honorable Governor of Tamil Nadu, stating that she should be disqualified from even continuing as a MLA. So that was the position on 27th September 2014. And we all knew at that point in time, and today also, 4 plus 6 years she could not
contest. You know, however you paint the picture, Sumansi Raman, until the appeal actually acquits her, she can't contest. And the appeal process could take a very long time, sometimes as much as 2 years. So she's already out of the next assembly race. And there isn't, the confidence value from the AIADMK of Jayalalitha coming out in the public domain hasn't happened in the past few weeks.
One second. There are two things. One is the Honorable Supreme Court has already requested, the daily application came up. The Honorable Supreme Court actually observed and said that, the Jayalalitha's side had been delaying the case in the trial court. And when Mr. Nariman has actually given an assurance saying that he will abide by the timeline stipulated by the Supreme Court, and then the Supreme Court said, you submit your documents by 18th of December and we will request the Karnataka High Court to expedite the appeal and complete it in 3 months thereafter. So I think that we are looking more realistically at a time frame closer to March or April, perhaps maximum of June of 2015, by which time we should get a verdict one way or the other as far as the appeal at the Karnataka High Court level is concerned. Thereafter, depending on what the verdict is, whether it goes to the Supreme Court or not, remains to be seen. So I don't believe that it's going to be 2 years, but certainly it's going to be the next 5-6 months. And as for her lying low, as you put it, I think one of the main reasons is that she's been extremely careful that not to do anything that could annoy the...
She's being extremely careful. All right, let's see if Mr. Murari agrees with you. Mr. Murari, the fact that Jayalalitha has been sort of out of the public glare, I mean, she's not a person who's always in the public glare, at least in her term in government. But she's really been out of it for some time. Is that thought provokingly well thought out, rather, or is it because she's feeling it that she might be missing from the political game?
See, first of all, it's a question of survival. Save herself before she can think of saving the government or the party. Her liberty is at stake. Going back to jail is not a joke. So she has abided by whatever conditions the Supreme Court has put. Because remember, the same thing happened to Chautala. He came out on bail on health grounds and then he campaigned in Haryana election. And she immediately put for cancellation of the bail. Jayalalitha doesn't want to. December 8th, they will know. Even if she is on bail, she cannot campaign also, not just contesting. She cannot even campaign. I don't think Sugati will allow. That means it's like a mockery of the commission. So she has to stay away from the election and get an acquittal, as Rama rightly said.
So, Mr. Murari, Mr. Venkatesh, we have now a very, very intriguing situation in the national politics of the country, where the lady who really runs, it's a one-woman party, the AIADMK, has a massive majority in the Tamil Nadu Assembly, has a significant number of MPs in the Lok Sabha as well as the Rajya Sabha, and yet she herself is facing political exile. How does this change the national picture? What do people like the BJP, for example, do when it comes to dealing with Jayalalitha?
BJP need not have to do anything to do with Jayalalitha because the courts are dealing with her. The process of law is taking its own course. As far as politically, BJP has a huge opportunity. The DMK, remember, by March, April, we could be having a 2G case verdict. And the DMK would be facing music. The enforcement directed cases of money laundering are also underway. And DMK is on the downward spiral. The ADMK, as you very rightly said, is also facing the court music. So if ADMK and DMK both are on a complete downward spiral,
then the BJP perhaps is hoping for a foot in the door. All right, so it just gets more intriguing as the political manipulations delve deeper. But certainly the news for Jayalalitha this evening is not looking good. Gentlemen, thank you for your thoughts.